This program is rated universal. Good for general watching.
Game On is brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Yes, indeed. The under-20 girls. Yes, this weekend they'll be hosting the clubs, the national side that is Tanzania in the FIFA under-20 World Cup qualifiers. Also, later this afternoon, the Uganda, starter in Uganda Premier League does get returned as well. Some major fixtures up ahead, including Pro Line up against Police. KCCA will be heading on the road, among so many other fixtures. Look out for in the league. Plus, elsewhere, there's the FMU elections. They're up ahead, and we've got a guest on the show that will be joining us for that particular conversation. And much later on, we'll be talking a bit of tennis. The first Grand Slam of the Australian Open is currently underway. And earlier today, the main man, that is Roger Federer, having to edge it in a decider. But there's much more fixtures up ahead when it comes down to the quarterfinals, both for the men and for the women. And certainly last night, there was a big win for Arsenal as they progress into the fifth round of the FA Cup. Mikel Arteta quite impressed by the youngsters. Later this evening, the EFL Cup semi-finals do take center stage. And that's the second legs. Aston Villa will be in action. And amongst so much more football up ahead. So hey, all that and so much more coming up. Welcome to the show. It's Game On. It's a Tuesday. We're proudly powered by 1xBet. And certainly, if you're looking to place a bet, you need to check out the website, which is 1xBet, and get to place your bet. But hey, that being said, my name is Brian Asimwe. I'll be joined by Sharon Adong for the next 1 hour. And we've got a guest on the show as well. That is Leon Senyange.
A pleasure. Pleasure being here. At least for the first time this year. But I've been here quite occasionally.
And, yeah.
Always a good moment, actually.
It's good to have you here. So many of us grew up watching Leon, and we're telling him off air that he set the bar for, you know, journalism and things like that. And today we get to host him a lot of to discuss on the show.
For me, I feel my dream has come true. Finally, I am sat with Leon Senyange. This is the second time I'm sitting with him together.
Administrator's course last week.
Yeah.
And we both passed, by the way.
Oh. And we both passed very well. And every time they kept on referring to journalists and what we are doing, it was either Sarah or it was Senyange.
Yeah.
And today, the second time I sit with him on the same show, I was jazzing him. How I used to admire him so much when I was in high school. I would watch TV till late in the night before going to read my books. I mean, because one time I even asked my dad, I said, but how can I be like that gentleman, Senyange? He said, read
you
hard,
are.
You will. But there I am today.
Thank you.
Okay. You're a jack of so many trades, a man that has been around, the seasoned journalist, and you've taken it to a whole other level and stepped into the car as well. And before we get to talk about, first of all, the reason that's why we have you here is because you're talking the upcoming Federation of Motorsport Uganda elections for the different positions, but most of all, we'll be focusing on the presidential seat. And I want to start there before we get to talk about the position you're vying for, which is the vice president. Four candidates in there, the incumbent, Duspanoki, there's Diapo Bamuno, Dipu Palelia, and Joseph Geoffrey Nsamba. What do you make of the four candidates?
Well, it's an interesting one. We now have a lineup of candidates that all have some good potential. They've been within the sport for quite some time. Dusman as an administrator, Jack as an administrator as well, Geoffrey as a competitor now vying into administration, Dipu as well as a competitor now getting into administration. I think over the next 4 years, we'll need more than just the face of the candidate. We'll need things to be done. We'll need to take several steps forward, and there should be key issues that the candidates should be able to tackle for them to, you know, try and elevate motorsport from what we've been over the last 4 or maybe 20 years to where we deserve to be. I say we deserve to be because there's a lot that is not being done, but there's potential to quite do several of these things.
Yeah, Sharon, clearly, I know you've got so many questions asked Leon as well, but, he's going to be vying for the position of vice president. Quite the step up, quite the challenging duty comes with lots of responsibilities, you think?
Well, first of all, it's going to be a very hard task for him, given the fact that motorsport...
You think so?
Yes, it is. Because you're going to get into office, I know.
Well,
that.
It's the position
you
for
will.
Deputy vice president, motorsport.
Okay.
Yeah, so essentially, I'll be in charge of... The competition side of motor rally.
Yes. Okay. What I was saying is going to quite be a little bit challenging for him when he gets to office is we've been looking quite in numbers of time that we have so many of these drivers who come on, but someone just gets excited, pull from there and say like hands and so kuvuga moto kanina subari nachi, and then someone gets driving. I mean, we still lack a lot of professionalism, right from quite of a number of factors. If you see how we can translate to see that we get sponsors on board and how to professionalize the sport itself. So for me, first of all, a huge task ahead of Leon Senyange. Senyange is a star, is a brand as Senyange. So all eyes are going to be on him. Even if the rest of the guys in the cabinet will fail, but it will be him to be blamed. So I don't know what it brings for us on board.
Well, bits and pieces of what she said could be a bit of a challenge she may seem to suggest, but I don't think so. I think I'm headstrong for the particular role I'm going for. I've been in motorsport. I started in motorsport about 2004 as a photographer and videographer, then stepped into the rally car in 2006, and I have gone through what you'd call the levels of motorsport locally, from competing in the two-wheel drive category, then the next level, which was the Clubman Rally Championship, then the National Rally Championship, and I've won titles in all those levels. So I very well know, and I've very much seen the things that most drivers go through, what competitors go through, and it is the very reason as to why I've you know, decided to quit the bucket seat for the administrative position. What do I bring on table? Rallying, many people think, is very expensive, and truthfully, it could be, but it depends on how you actually approach motorsport. I'm pushing very much so for cost-effective rallying, and that is where she says that a driver shows up and they think they can beat a guy who was a seasoned driver. I believe that for somebody to start, they need to start small, and then you grow through the ranks. And we have a couple of drivers who want to start big, but you know they can't stay big at the top. And for me, the advocacy here is to talk to those that want to come in and tell them, you know what, if you rush, you crash. Take your time, take it in its strides, learn the regulations, learn how to learn the progressive, get the progressive curve on how you can get to the top. And once you have a cluster of those kind of drivers, over the next 4 or 5 years, then you have drivers who have been there, known the process, and they now can compete and stay in the sport. That for me is one of the things I'm pushing, cost effective
rally. What inspires you before Brian comes in? What is that thing that, because it's something very rare, this is a journalist, you know, he's a sports journalist, and then all of a sudden, pooh, you're hearing is a rally driver. What really inspired you so much? What's so special about the sport?
Rallying is a passion. I always have a hashtag that says follow your passion. So it's one of those things that keep me going. My parents have told me before that I used to love cars, toy cars that used to make a lot of noise. I didn't quite understand what it meant then. Then later on, about 1993, 94, there was a rally at the International Conference Center then, which is now Serena. And mom took me there and saw this kind of cars, and I was really excited. So in between, I went to Masaka. There was a time when rally cars passed by the school gate. I remember Rasta Rob was driving at that time. So yeah, it kept growing. Then, of course, the World Rally Championship was in our face. Internet came to Kampala, and we could see pictures, and you'd admire that kind of stuff. Then we used to have the VHS tapes. So there's a guy in Kabalagala I used to go to who would record for me, and he gives me the VHS, and would watch the WRCs. Then, of course, joining journalism, went into photography, videography as well. And I thought to myself, why not get into the bucket seat itself? And that's how very much started to where I am now.
FMU, there is an incumbent, Usman Oki. Some of the biggest challenges has been leadership, building structures. I read one of the manifestos, I think from Deepu Parelia. One of the things he talked about was that he's looking to build the brand so that he can attract all his partners, all his sponsors as well. What do you think are some of the key pressing issues for FMU?
I think from top to bottom, one of the major things is training and empowerment. I entirely believe that we need to be educated as a fraternity. We need to have small things like a management course for whoever wants to take any position in the federation, even at the club level. We need to be educated on the regulations, not just the officials, but also drivers, even marshals, anybody, we need to be educated around things on safety. So once you have a cluster of people that are empowered with knowledge, then you have a cluster of people that can actually work and have things done in a streamlined way. That doesn't go to say that we haven't been doing things in a streamlined way. We surely have been doing that. Yeah. But a little bit of an addition to that will make us a better lot as a motorsport fraternity. So yes, Leon, empowerment comes in as a key issue.
I love the empowerment bit of it. You know, I'm so passionate about women, so much. What is the feature of women? What do you see the feature of women in motorsport when it comes to, besides being a rally driver? Because apparently you can only talk about this Susan Mwonge, but we want to feel to see so many other women on board, besides beyond pitch, I mean driving, but also in leadership. So what is the future for women in this?
There's quite a great deal of opportunity for women in motorsport. The Federation in its constitution has a commission for women. It's one that hasn't been, and I'll admit, hasn't been exploited by the women within motorsport. There is capacity. We have several females who are marshalling. We have a female scrutineer, the one that checks the cars before the race. We have the drivers. We have the navigators as well. Yeah. And we have those 1, 2, 3 who are in administration. But again, it goes back to what I was saying. We need to empower ourselves as a fraternity such that tomorrow, If Sharon here, Sarah here, has a slot she wants to contest for, she has the knowledge, she has the confidence, and she can say, you know what, I can contest for this position and I truly deserve it. We have only one female contesting in the election coming on Friday, which I find rather absurd. Our females need to be able to step a bit more into the real.
So me who has never been a rally driver, if I would want to contest, would I contest?
The regulations wouldn't quite allow you because you need to have been at least 5 or more years within administration or competition. Okay. So what as it is now,
it's hard.
Leon, in the event that she elected deputy vice president of FMU, certainly it's a whole ecosystem. You know, there's drivers, there's clubs in there, there's funds, there's regulators, there's so many people that are involved in the process. Anything you think that, you know, you could want to put together to pretty much help the sport move forward?
It comes back down to what I stand for. I stand for cost-effective rallying, training opportunities for one, clubs, drivers, and anybody within the fraternity. I stand for better relations, and like you said, the ecosystem. We need to be, while I'm in charge of motor rallying, how then do I work with somebody in vintage? How well do I work with the general secretary? How well do I work with a driver to ensure that, you know, everything is quite in tandem for us to have a very good event and have very good things going. That is relations, but most of all, and the key of it all, is communication. Without that, and the flaws that probably exist or lack, you find that things won't be able to move. If you don't communicate to a driver when they can get a competition license, then that driver will become a challenge to you. But yeah, so going forward, those are the key things: cost-effective rallying, better relations, training opportunities, and communication as well.
Okay, Sharon, as we get to wrap up this particular conversation, for people running for the top spot, certainly Leon is in his own category as well. What should we expect from the new leadership as they get to take office?
For me, first of all, I expect a lot of spices around in the leadership setup. More so, really, God should help us for Leon Sengale to go through. Because,
well, you should ask the assembly.
Leadership comes from God, by the way. It's a fact. It's God who decides. None of us knows our destiny. Like me, I'm going to contest in 2021, but it's only God who knows my destiny. Sure. So, like, I am pleading to God, the Creator. Leon should go through. And if Leon goes through, we're going to see a number of changes and putting a little, uplifting the face value of the industry. Because, yes, it has been very active. We've been performing so well. But there are key areas we talked about, like issues of communication, some areas of strategic planning we need to have and see how we can bring more fans on board. And having Leon definitely is going to light up the whole administration.
All right, finally, as we get to wrap it up, the elections are coming up the 1st of February. There's an electoral committee that has already been put in place. You know, the candidates, everyone has submitted their applications. Any final words as wrap this up, Leon?
Well, ultimately for me, it's about going to the motorsport fraternity and telling everybody they're in, we need a direction. over the next 4 years, we need to start something that gets motorsport from here to this level. Yeah. We have seen football evolve, yeah, and motorsport can evolve. And I ask very many, do we have the will to make motorsport better? Yeah. I entirely believe we do.
Okay, thank you so much, Leon.
A pleasure.
Hope to see you again soon.
after Saturday.
When is the election process?
On Saturday, Saturday at Katikati. Yeah, after the annual assembly, then the elective assembly.
Thank you. Just pay your cards right.
Well,
I mean, the victory is ours.
Yeah.
Fantastic. Thank you. Thank you for the wishes.
There you go. That is Leon Senyange for you vying for the post of Deputy Vice President. But we're going to head into a short break. When we come back after the break, the FIFA General Secretary Fatma Samora is in the country. We'll be discussing some of the key activities she's been taking part in. Like we mentioned, the Uganda Premier League does return later this afternoon. Some key fixtures to look out for. Plus, up ahead, the FIFA Under 20 World Cup qualifiers do return this weekend, and the Under 20 girls under the head coach Olivier Mbekeka will certainly be getting ready to pretty much battle it out for a place in the next round. Plus, later on, there is tennis, there is football, and so much more as well. You're watching Game On, powered by One Expert.
Game on! It's game on! We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game On is brought to you by.
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.